Welcome to the Third Rail, where I don't think anyone even remembers the series, so just watch the old episodes here. There's some links in the description. Go nuts. Because it's Australia Day today, here is the Australia episode. Early, because Ecuador still has to finish their metro. Let's start out in Rockingham, Western Australia. It has a proposed light rail heading out from the station. You can see where it would be along a busway that heads out of it. Just to the north, you have the Perth Rail Network. This network was originally just a Fremantle line before closing down completely in 1979. It would then reopen in 1983, then it would be electrified in 1991, along with rapid expansion of a whole network. In Fremantle, here was an old tram network, as well as in the rural town of Kalgoorlie. Perth also had a pretty big tram network. Rockhampton had a steam train from 1909 to 1939. There is a museum for it at Archer Park Station. Now we have Brisbane. 1979, it opens. It has suburban lines as well as intercity lines to the cities of the Sunshine Coast and the Gold Coast. Brisbane used to have a huge tram line with lots of remnants still around to this day. In Ferny Grove, you can find the old Brisbane Tramway Museum. That is the worst typo I have ever made in my life. It's supposed to say Brisbane Tramway Museum. How did I mess up that bad? There is a proposed light rail for the Sunshine Coast, however the Gold Coast already has it. But before we head down there, let's address one of the three elephants in the Queensland room. In 1988, for the Brisbane World Expo, there was a Von Roll monorail built for it. It would be torn down when the whole expo would shut down the next year, obviously. Then you have the Gold Coast, the monorail capital of Australia. Beginning in the north, you have the SeaWorld monorail system, the only one still in operation. Until 2017, there was a monorail in the Broadbeach shopping centre. Both of these were Von Roll monorail systems. It also has the huge Gold Coast light rail, which will soon become an interstate light rail to Tweed Heads. Heading south a bit, you have the Byron Bay Solar Train, the only solar-powered train in the world. It heads along part of the closed Moolumbah railway line between two stations, Byron Beach and North Beach. Weirdly, it doesn't use the massive Heritage Byron Bay station just below Byron Beach. It opened in 2017. Maitland has the Hunter Line, an intercity railway network heading to Newcastle Interchange, Dungog and Scone. Speaking of Newcastle, it has a light rail and heavy rail network. The aforementioned Hunter Line and Central Coast Line operate suburban areas, while the Newcastle Light Rail operates from Newcastle Interchange to the Newcastle Beach, straight through the city. And at Honeysuckle, it heads along the old Newcastle Railway Line. This was a railway line that had a huge station where Newcastle Beach is, which is now a park. The same is at Civic, where it had its own station. The cities of Maitland and Newcastle used to have big tram networks before they shut down. Sydney, my city. It has 8 railway lines, 1 metro line, the only one in Australia, opened in May 2019, I think, and soon 5 light rail lines. A neat thing about Sydney is that all of its trains, or most of its trains, are all double-decker, a very rare trait. From 1988 to 2013, it had the Sydney monorail, something that was famous but was pointless and went to nowhere in the end. The light rail lines are the L1 Dulwich Hill line, built on the old Darling Harbour Goods line, the L2 Randwick line, built on the old tram network, L3 Juniors Kingsford line, or, as I spelt it, Junior's Kingsford line, also built on the old tram network. Under construction, L4 Parramatta line, built on the old Parramatta light rail network, and the Carlingford railway line, and the South Pacific Electric Railway, a short heritage tram museum from Waratah Loop to the Royal National Park, built on the old Royal National Park railway line. Speaking of, Sydney used to have one of the biggest tram networks in the world. It also has the B1 BRT from City Wynyard to Mona Vale, and the Northwest to and the Northwest and Liverpool transitways. Wollongong has, of course, the South Coast Line, as well as local services to Port Kembla listed as T4 services somehow. Broken Hill, a town in the middle of nowhere, had the Silverton Tramway, actually a private railway, they just called it a tram so that they could operate, and an actual steam tramway. Yes, really, it was a pretty big network as well. Yass had a suburban rail line heading from the junction to the town. The whole line is now abandoned. The museum at a town terminus. I've done a video exploring the whole line, go watch it now. Yass Junction Station is still open. Perisher Valley has the Ski Tube, the only alpine railway in Australia, except for the Blue Mountains line, but it doesn't really count. South Australia has Adelaide, which has the train network, half diesel, half electric, the tram network, and the Oban Busway. Victor Harbour has a heritage railway and horse tramway. Tasmania had tram lines in Hobart and Launceston, however these have completely gone. To Victoria, the tram capital. Ballarat has a small heritage tram that goes on one side of Lake Wendouree. It used to have a massive network. Bendigo has a huge heritage tram, which used to be part of a big network as well. Geelong sadly doesn't have a heritage tram, but did have a big network. All three of these cities have intercity services from them and Melbourne. Melbourne has the biggest tram network in the world. It is so big. My favourite line is Route 96, which is a light rail line running on the old St Kilda train line. Melbourne also owns a sizeable train network, with an under-construction underground line. There is a heritage tram line in Portland, the only cable tram still in Australia, although it's actually diesel-powered, it's just using old cable trams, but whatever. Finally, there was a small network in Sorrento. I'm putting this in post since I completely forgot about these somehow. First, there is the Perth Tram Museum in Whiteman Park. Secondly, there is the Canberra Metro, a newly opened light rail line in the capital city of Canberra. Thirdly, there is the Pemberton Tramway, a small rural tram line in Pemberton, Western Australia. So, that is Australia done. I hope you enjoyed this video. Next video will hopefully be Ecuador, and if not, then we're moving to Mexico.
Check it out.